Now let us try to prove this. That is, if there is a point that lies on the perpendicular bisector of a line segment joining two fixed points, then that point that lies on the perpendicular bisector would be equidistant from the two fixed points. Let us look at this. Let us say we have these two fixed points as A and B. So this is the line segment that is joining A and B, line segment AB. Let us say that MQ is the perpendicular bisector of AB. Perpendicular bisector of AB, that means that it should be perpendicular to AB. So this is 90 degrees, perpendicular to AB. And M is the midpoint of AB. So this point M is the midpoint of AB. That is AM is equal to MB. This is what we know. Now let us consider a point P. So this point P is any point which is on this perpendicular bisector MQ. So I've taken this point P to be here, which is on the perpendicular bisector MQ. Now what do I want to prove? First, let's see what is given to us. We are given two fixed points, A and B. We are given that MQ is the perpendicular bisector of this line AB. That is, it is perpendicular, as well as M is the midpoint. Also, we have a point P, which is any point on this line MQ. Now, what do I want to prove? I want to prove that a point which lies on the perpendicular bisector is equidistant from these two fixed points, which is A and B. So, I want to prove that AP would be equal to BP. This is what I want to prove. So, I want to prove that AP is equal to BP. Now, for that, what I'll do is, I'll join the lines. I'll join AP and BP. So, let us join these two lines. So, I join AP and BP. Now, let's look at these two triangles. That is triangle PAM and triangle PBM. Let's color these two triangles and look at these two triangles. In these two triangles, what do you observe? We know that AM is equal to MB because M is the midpoint. So AM is equal to MB because M is the midpoint. The second thing what you observe is that this angle here, which is angle 1, let's call this angle 2. So angle 1 and 2 are same. Why? Because they are 90 degrees each. Since MQ is perpendicular to AB, these two angles are 90 degrees. So next what I can say is that angle 1 is equal to angle 2 because MQ is perpendicular to AB. What is the third thing which you can observe? Note this line PM. Now this line is there in triangle PAM. This line is also there in triangle PBM. So this is a line which is common to both the triangles. So I can say that PM is equal to PM. That is common in both. So this is what I get. MP is common in both the lines. MP is common in both the triangles. So I have a pair of line, a pair of angle, and another pair of line. So I have side, angle, side, again, side, angle, side. So I can say that these two triangles are congruent by side, angle, side. So, triangle PAM and triangle PBM are congruent by side, angle, side. Now, since these triangles are congruent, we know when triangles are congruent, the corresponding parts of the triangles are also congruent. So, let's look at the corresponding parts. That means PA would be equal to PB. Corresponding parts. So I can say that PA would be equal to PB by CPCT. That is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So this is what I get. AP would be equal to BP. So this is AP, this is BP, and this is what I get is equal by CPCT. And this is exactly what I wanted to prove. So I'm done with the proof here. This is what we've seen. Now, what we've told is that if there is a point that lies on the perpendicular bisector, it is equidistant from both these fixed points. Now, let us look at the converse of this. That is, if there is a point which is equidistant from two fixed points, then that point would lie on the perpendicular bisector. So let us say these are the two fixed points, A and B. And let us say that P is a point which is equidistant from both these points, A and B. So we have that PA is equal to PB, since it is equidistant from both these points. Now what I want to prove is that P lies on the perpendicular bisector of a line that joins A and B. So we are given two fixed points, A and B. P is a moving point such that AP is equal to PB. What I want to prove is that P lies on the perpendicular bisector of this line which joins AB. So for construction, what I'll do is I'll join A and B. So I'll join A and B. Let M be the midpoint of A and B, and I'll join PM also. So I join AB, M is the midpoint, and now let's join M and P. So this is what I get. Now let's look at triangles PAM and triangle PBM. So I'll color these two triangles. Let us observe these two triangles now. What we know is that PA is equal to PB, or I can say AP is equal to BP. Same thing, AP is equal to BP. This is given to us. It is given that AP is equal to BP. So this is the first thing which I know, that is AP is equal to BP. Now let's look at the second thing. AM is equal to MB because M is the midpoint. So AM would be equal to MB. So I can say that AM is equal to MB because M is the midpoint. This is by construction. We had drawn M in such a way that it was a midpoint of AB. Now let's look at the third thing. Observe this line, MP. Now this is there in this triangle also, that is in triangle PAM. This line PM is also there in triangle PBM. So this line is common in both the triangles. So what I can say is that MP is equal to MP since it's common in both the triangles. So I have three pairs of side in one triangle which are equal to three pairs of side in the other triangle. So side, side, side and side. So by these three sides I can say that these two triangles are congruent. So I can say that triangle PAM is congruent to triangle PBM by side, side, side. Now once the triangles are congruent, the corresponding parts of these triangles will also be congruent. So let us call this as angle 1 and this as angle 2. So I can say that angle 1 would be equal to angle 2 by CPCT. That is the corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So this is what I get. Now observe angle 1 and 2. They both lie on this straight line which is AMB. AMB is a straight line and angle 1 and 2 lie on this straight line. So I can say that angle 1 plus angle 2 would be equal to 180 degrees because they are lying on the straight line. So I can say that angle 1 plus angle 2 would be equal to 180 degrees. Now angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So I can say angle 1 plus angle 1 is 180 degrees, or I can say that angle 1 would be 180 by 2, which is 90 degrees. So I get that angle 1 would be equal to 90 degrees and angle 2 is equal to angle 1. So both angle 1 and angle 2 would be 90 degrees. So this is what I get. Both angle 1 and 2 are 90 degrees. Now since they are 90 degrees, and M is the midpoint. Now observe PM. PM is a line which is bisecting AB because M is the midpoint. So AM is equal to MB. Further, what we see is that PM is not just bisecting this line, but it is also perpendicular to it because this is 90 and this is 90. So I can say that PM is perpendicular bisector of AB. So now I can say that PM or MP would be the perpendicular bisector of this line AB. Now if MP is the perpendicular bisector, then any point that lies on it, P lies on that point. So P is a point that lies on the perpendicular bisector of AB. This is what I wanted to prove. So I have a point P which was equidistant to both these fixed points. What I get is that this point P, if it is equidistant to two fixed points, it would lie on the perpendicular bisector of the line segment which is joining these two fixed points. So when you have two fixed points and you have to find locus of all such points that are equidistant from these two fixed points, then that gives me a straight line which would be perpendicular bisector to the line segment that is joining these two fixed points. So I have these two fixed points. This point is the midpoint. Let's say it is M. So PM is equal to MQ. And this line is not just bisecting PQ, but it is also perpendicular to PQ. So this line, which is the locus of all such points which are equidistant from two fixed points, gives me perpendicular bisector of the line PQ. So now the question was, where could we put this swimming pool? We have communities Y and Z, and we wanted to make this swimming pool equidistant from both these communities to be fair to them. So now I wanted points which are equidistant from these two fixed points. So all such points would lie on the perpendicular bisector of the line which joins these two points. So if YZ is the line joining the two fixed points Y and Z, let's say that AB is the perpendicular bisector. It is perpendicular and it is bisecting the line also. So locus of all such points which are equidistant from two fixed points gives me a perpendicular bisector, which is the perpendicular bisector of the line that joins these two fixed points.